You know that little delay that exists between saving your code and seeing the result? Like maybe you're writing JavaScript and you're waiting for Webpack to compile. Or maybe you're writing vanilla HTML and you're hitting refresh to check your changes. Whatever kind of code you're writing, there's a delay that exists between making a change and seeing if that change does what you want. I want to focus on that delay. It's small, but it's significant. Because when you write code, you encounter this delay over and over and over again. Because when you write code, you operate in a loop. Let's call it the programming feedback loop. Here's what I mean. First, you write code. Then, you save your changes. Next, there's that delay I've been talking about. Your computer is compiling code or whatever. Finally, you see your changes and decide whether or not that's the result you want. Repeat this loop until your task is done. That's the programming feedback loop. Write code, get feedback, repeat. Now back to this delay. This delay acts as a speed limit on how quickly you can iterate through the loop. Because of this, you want the delay to be as short as possible. A shorter delay means you get feedback faster. You can make mistakes without being punished for them. You can stay in a constant flow without having your concentration broken. How do you make this delay shorter? That depends a lot on the kind of work you're doing. Maybe you can optimize the build tasks that run whenever you save a file, or maybe you can install a plugin that catches errors before the delay occurs. Maybe you can install a plugin that hot reloads your changes right after you save them, no refresh necessary. You probably have to answer this question yourself based on your environment and setup. Sometimes you can almost eliminate the delay entirely. A lot of programming languages have a tool called a REPL, which lets you evaluate little bits of code rather than a whole file. This gets you really quick feedback. Or if you're writing HTML and CSS, consider using DevTools for that instant visual feedback on markup and styling changes. Both of these solutions let you circumvent the feedback loop. So be on the lookout for other situations where you can solve problems in this zero delay space. The programming feedback loop is something we participate in every day, but it's something we rarely talk and think about directly. Being aware of these steps and making efforts to improve them can make us more productive, focused, and happy.